What is up, guys? Mauen here from MauGT. Sorry I haven't uploaded in a while. I have been, once again, very busy with school. But instead of getting to the apologies, let's go ahead and skip right to the video I have for you guys. DualShock 4 versus Xbox One S controller 2017. Now, I'm sure you've seen comparisons like this all over YouTube. Comparisons trying to figure out which is the better controller, which controller works better, you know, which controller or which console you should pick up. Now, I fully support both the PS4 and both the Xbox One. I think they are both great consoles. Now, I do show a bit of favoritism towards the Xbox One, but I do think the PS4 is a great console. Now, I don't have either console, but I have played both consoles. This is a friend's controller that I am borrowing for this video, and this is my controller. Once again, I do not have an Xbox One or a PS4. I picked up this controller so I could play PC games on my laptop. But I will be comparing both controllers, talking about different things that they can do, what they're capable of in 2017, and stuff like that. So let's go ahead and get into the video. Now, both controllers Each controller has a different design language. So the DualShock 4 has a much wider body than the Xbox One controller. Both of the thumbsticks are side by side, with the D-pad in the position of the left thumbstick on the Xbox One S controller, and the ABXY or triangle, circle, cross, square buttons in the same position. Now you have share and option buttons versus view and menu buttons here. D-pads are in different positions. And probably one of the biggest differences you'll notice just looking at the controllers is the DualShock 4 has a touchpad right here. I don't believe it is a multi-touch touchpad, but it does click in different places. The DualShock 4 also has a speaker, and the PS button, which would be equivalent to the guide button on the Xbox One, is at the bottom there, while this is at the top here. Now the PS button is a multi-function button. It's used to turn on the controller, turn off the controller, and put the controller in pairing mode. The Xbox One S controller, however, has a guide button and a pairing button at the top of the controller. Now the reason why I'm referring to this as the Xbox One S controller instead of just the Xbox One controller is because there are differences between the two. The Xbox One S controller has improved range, better battery life, and has built-in Bluetooth, which means it can connect to Windows 10, PCs, and select Android smartphones, which is one advantage the DualShock 4 has over the Xbox One S controller. The DualShock 4 can connect to pretty much any Android device out there, but if your device is not running Android 6.0 or below, chances are you are not going to be able to connect your Xbox One S controller. Now, let's more closely compare the looks of the two controllers. So, I've already compared the face of the controllers, the position of all the buttons, sticks, D-pad, stuff like that. The bottom of the controllers is similar. You've got a proprietary accessory port for headsets, keyboards, things like that, and a 3.5mm headset jack. Same thing on the DualShock 4 controller here. You've got a proprietary port for accessories and a 3.5mm headphone jack. On the back of each controller, the DualShock 4 has a built-in lithium-ion battery. So you recharge it using the micro USB port here. The Xbox One S controller still takes dual AA batteries, but you can purchase the Play and Charge kit and plop a rechargeable battery in there if you want. Now I'm currently using these Aneloop Panasonic rechargeable batteries. They don't recharge in the controller, but they come with their own charger, so all I have to do is swap them out when I need a quick charge. The controller comes with two AA Duracell batteries, but I have tossed those in favor of the ones that I've got in here. This little notch in the back here, some think it's a speaker, but it is not. The accessories that plug into this clip on here for extra grip. Now looking at the top of the controllers, the touchpad on the DualShock 4 extends here. You've got your R1 and L1, and you've got your R2 and L2. Now the triggers on both controllers feel substantial. However, the triggers on the Xbox One S controller are a little bit tighter. Now, I haven't used this controller very much, so maybe it's because these triggers are worn down. I haven't really gotten my hands on a brand new PS4 controller, but the triggers definitely feel a little more loose. Not like loose in a cheap way, but there's not as much resistance to the triggers as there is to these. Now, the bumpers are less clicky than these. You can hear a distinguished click on these bumpers as opposed to these, and it doesn't really change much. However, these bumpers, I would say, have a little bit less travel. The triggers feel like they have about the same travel on both controllers, and it's once again just your personal preference. Now, also on the top of the controllers, both controllers have micro USB ports for charging. Both have respective branding. As you can see right there, you've got Xbox branding right there, and Sony's branding right here. Directly below that light bar is that light bar, which when you turn on the controller, it can flash different colors to indicate battery life, which player you are in game, or whatever the developer wants to. The Xbox One S does not have anything like that, but there is a backlit LED behind this guide button. You've got your pairing button at the top here, the touchpad just extends over, and once again you've got the micro USB ports. Now there's this very small little hole there, and I believe that is to reset the controller. I'm not entirely sure, but once again this is a friend's controller, so I'm not going to try anything. You've got four screws to gain access to the DualShock 4. However, this is a completely closed off design. I'm pretty sure there are clips all around this thing holding it together, but I'm also not going to take apart this because I don't know if I'd be able to put it back together. Probably could, but I'm not sure. Both controllers feel good in the hand. Like I said, the DualShock 4 is a bit wider. It may not look that way, but holding it in your hands, it definitely is a much wider controller. I prefer the fit and feel of the Xbox One wireless controller, or Xbox One S wireless controller. The thumbsticks, the grip on the thumbsticks is a little better for me. I find that my thumb slips off of this thumbstick. I don't really play much of COD or any other of those first-person shooters, Battlefield. I don't really play intense games like that. I play mostly racing simulators, role-playing games, very subtle, laid-back, relaxed games. And I have to say, for those kinds of games, I would definitely prefer the Xbox One wireless controller. The thumbstick grip, it holds onto my thumb a lot better than the DualShock 4 does. My thumb often slips off of these thumbsticks. Okay, now the reason why this is pink is because I just pressed the PS button, and I have some software installed on my computer, which I will show you guys in just a second, but let me go ahead and power off the controller. So the controller does feature Bluetooth, both controllers do feature Bluetooth, and both controllers are capable of connecting to Windows PCs. But this, if you're talking about a gamepad for mobile gaming, it'd probably be wise to pick up the DualShock 4 because it connects to pretty much any Android device out there. So once again, like I was saying, I would definitely prefer the Xbox One S wireless controller during gameplay. The grip is better. I mean, I have done long gaming sessions with both controllers before I made this video, just to make sure, you know, I'm giving you guys accurate information based on my testing. While the grip is all around the back of the controller, I find that after maybe an hour and a half, this gets more slippery than the grip on this. They both get slippery, but this gets a little less slippery, and I can hold onto this a lot better than I can the DualShock 4 controller. Now, to turn on the controllers, you press their respective guide buttons. Pressing and holding this turns on the Xbox One wireless controller, and it's a solid, which means it's automatically connected to my computer. Go ahead and press this once, don't even have to hold it down, and it should automatically pair to my computer. So both of these are connected to my Windows 10 PC, which I will bring in right now. Let me go ahead and move some stuff out of the way. All right, let's go ahead and bring this up on my laptop's display. Scoot this over a little bit. Level the camera out. Alrighty. So this is my laptop. I'm sure you guys have seen it plenty of times by now. I'm gonna go ahead and unlock it. Everything should be up and running. All right. Close window. One second, guys. Quit. Computer is being a little unresponsive. I will skip to when I've got it working. Oh, never mind. All right, so the program that I wanted to show you for the, first, let's go ahead and hop into the settings here. Go ahead and zoom in. Adjust the angle. That's better. Zoom in. All right. So if we go to devices, go to Bluetooth. So you can see wireless controller is the representation for the DualShock 4. And then if we go down, you'll see we've got Xbox wireless controller. So it doesn't necessarily recognize this exactly as a DualShock 4, but it just recognizes it as a standard wireless controller. Same as if you were to connect it to an Android device. Now the program that I want to show you, it's hanging for some reason, okay. Now the program that I want to show you is called DS4 Windows. It is a kind of like an emulation program for the DualShock 4, and it lets you see readouts, different configurations of the controller. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn this down so I can get to that. And then I will pull it back up once I've got it pulled up. Now there's a similar piece of software that I found for the Xbox One wireless controller, and it's called Game Controller Tester. It's a free app on the Windows Store, but that's only on Windows 10. Not sure if it's on Windows 8 and 8.1, but you can definitely find it for free on the Windows 10 Store. So go ahead and double click that. DS4 Windows. Okay. So, this is... Oh, that's not good. Focus. There you go. This is DS4 Windows. So, if we go to controllers... That's weird. Go ahead and bring this up. If we hit stop, and then hit start. Now, the light is pink. Now, normally it'd be blue, but with DS4 Windows, you can change the color of the light bar. The light bar is an LED light bar, so there are multiple different color possibilities. So we go ahead and tilt the screen down a little bit. So, right off the bat, one interesting thing that I found is you can use the touchpad to control the mouse. Now, wireless connection to the program, has a little bit of latency, which kind of sucks. If you take a look at the bottom right of the window there, one second. Just gotta adjust something on my tripod here. Alright, take a look at that. You can see controller 1's latency now under 10 milliseconds. Controller 1's latency. So it changes based on the latency. And you can see the reflection of the light bar on my screen there. So I can use this to control, I can use the touchpad on the DS4. Yes, I realize I am zoomed in. Focus, there we go. You can use the touchpad to control the mouse on the DS, to control the mouse on your computer, which is a pretty nifty feature. And you can also use the gyroscope, the 6-axis gyroscope built into the DualShock 4 to control the mouse as well. Now, in this video, I will not be playing any games. This is strictly just a comparison between the Xbox One S and PS4 and DualShock 4 wireless controllers and the features that they have. So just take a look at the reflection of the light bar right there. Hit Define Custom Colors and just take a look at the reflection of the light bar and watch it change colors. So I can change the color of the light bar on the fly. Now the reflection might not be showing it off to the best ability, so I'm just going to turn the controller around here. And where is my mouse control? Okay, it's over here. So you can change the color of the light bar to whatever color you want. The hue, you can change pretty much everything about the controller, and it's a really cool program. So now if we go to profiles, or if we go to edit, we can edit the current profile. So if I go here, see that option right there that says use gyro for the mouse? You can see now, as I move the DualShock 4, it moves the mouse. Now, in personal experience, that feature does not work as well as I would like it to, but it does work. Now, you can also go to controller readings. You can see that there is an input delay. Go ahead and zoom out here a little bit. Sorry if the camera is not level. I have used this tripod before, but I am not necessarily all that familiar with it. So let's zoom in here. So we can see you have the 6-axis readouts right here. So as I move the controller, you can see that little black dot will move there. So then you can look at the boxes that say right stick, left stick. And as I move the left stick, that little dot moves as well. Right stick, same here. You can look down there where it says gyro and accelerometer. You've got the readouts for that. As you can see, as I move the controller, those move as well. Now as far as I know, there's no way for the camera to read the exact color of the light bar. That would be really cool. Maybe they'll add it in a future update. And then you can see also down here, right there, as I move the triggers, it shows me the readout for that as well. Now, if we take a look at the top right corner of the software, right there, where it says rumble, test heavy, test light. If I click test heavy, the controller starts to vibrate in my hand. And I don't know if you can hear it, let me put it up next to the microphone. You might be able to hear that, you might not. But I can test the vibration of the controller. And if I just set the controller down, the vibration is currently on. I'll take a look at the six-axis reading. You can see the dot starts to move, and the gyro and acceleration things, they start to go crazy because of the vibration. I can change the percentage or the strength of the rumble feature. Up to 150. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the controller. Let's go ahead and zoom. Oh, that's not good. Okay. Let's go ahead and zoom out. I don't know if you can see it, but the controller is moving. I'll kind of zoom in on it just a little bit. You can see the controller is shaking. So that's a pretty nifty feature of the software. You can test the vibration motors and change the strength. Let's go ahead and stop that. So, and you can also allow it, and if you click this, the light bar will flash when there is latency. So that is DS4 Windows. I'm gonna go ahead and go to controllers and hit stop. So once you hit stop, the DS4 Windows program no longer communicates with the DualShock 4, and it just changes to a standard white light bar color. So let's go and wait for that to close out. All right. Now let's check out the piece of software that I found for the Xbox One S wireless controller. Game controller tester. So you can see that's connected there. Zoom out a little bit. You've got the same readouts just like the DualShock 4 controller. That's the left thumb stick and then the right thumb stick, as well as the triggers. Now, this software does work a little bit better when the controller is connected using a cable. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. Just any standard micro USB cable works. And you can see it still is connected. Now if we click buzz, ooh, that was close. It will buzz the controller. We can go to vibration, hit impulse triggers, and as you know, one of the things that I prefer over the DualShock 4, between DualShock 4 and Xbox One wireless controller, let me just zoom out here, is the triggers themselves have their own vibration motors. So in certain games, you can feel the vibration instead of in the entire controller. You'll feel it just in the trigger. So let me see if you guys can hear this. Now they get quite loud. Now whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, I wouldn't know. But it does certainly work. So that's the game controller tester. Now, the Xbox One wireless controller doesn't have as many features as the DualShock 4 does, but it's still very feature-packed, and that software can do a lot of things. Now, because this is Windows, and Windows is by Microsoft, Xbox is a Microsoft product, the Xbox One controller does have a few advantages over the DualShock 4, which is why I prefer it for PC gaming. Native controller support. So, the Xbox One wireless controller, or Xbox One S wireless controller, has native Windows gaming support, which means pretty much all of your games that support controllers will work natively with the Xbox One wireless controller, no configuration necessary. I'll show this off in a later video, but you can see just if I press the Xbox button, the Windows 10 game bar should shortly appear. If you just give it a second. That's strange. Let's try that again. Usually just immediately appears. Now, one thing I don't like about the controller is after a while, after a pairing and unpairing process, you do have to repair the controller every once in a while, which is actually pretty easy to do. You just hold the pairing button at the top of the controller. The Xbox button will start to flash rapidly. Go ahead and select pair. And it will change to Xbox wireless controller in just a second. Zoom in on that. Should change shortly. But right now what it's doing is loading all the drivers. Now, if you pick up the PS4 or DualShock 4 controller and we press the PS button, the guide might come up, but it doesn't look like it does. You can see that changed to Xbox wireless controller. Let's go ahead and try pressing this again to bring up the game bar. And there it is. Now, having the DualShock 4 connected glitches that out, so we're going to go ahead and turn it off by holding the PS button, and the little light on the top of the controller should just go out. Let's go ahead and zoom out and zoom in on the game bar. It is glitching out and should not be. Let's go ahead and summon it again. Once again, to summon it, all you have to do is press the Xbox button. Now, like I said, it is glitching out for whatever reason. But, you can press it to summon it. Now, if you're running the Steam beta client, and I can show that really quickly before I close off the video. I don't want this video to be too terribly long. But if we go ahead and launch Steam here, using a Steam close. Okay, so if we go ahead and open Big Picture Mode for Steam, Big Picture Mode is basically like a full immersed Steam experience. So this is Big Picture Mode in Steam. So basically, the Steam natively recognizes the controller, and I can use it to navigate the Steam Big Picture interface. If I go to settings here and controller settings, you can see it does recognize right there zoom in, you can see it recognizes the Xbox One S wireless controller. I've paired it before, so I named it, and then it detects PS4 controller. So I can let me re-enable this. So I can enable PS4 configuration support. Go ahead and turn on the PS4 controller. And you can see now I can control the interface with the PS4 controller. So if you go up here, it says PlayStation gamepad detected, a Steam controller PS4 configuration support is enabled. It will then be reconfigurable per game using the same configuration system available to Steam controllers. So if I hit X, now the PS4 controller has now the thing about the PS4 controller is it's emulated directly, or it's based pretty much on the Steam controller, because it has its own touchpad and everything like that. So it's pretty much just like the Steam controller, which makes easier for configuration. Now I will show you more in depth how this software works, but for now, that's it for this video, guys. Let's go ahead and close this. So, these two controllers, they are both very, very good controllers. I like them both a lot. I support them both a lot, support their respective consoles. Once again, if I had to pick a controller, I would probably pick this controller. It's better supported on PC. It fits better in my hand. Thumbsticks are better for me. I just overall like this controller a lot more. I have nothing against the DS4. It is a very, very nice controller. It's very well built. It's lightweight, sturdy, very durable. And I would definitely use this controller on a regular basis if I needed to as well. That's it for this video, guys. I will probably link where you can buy both of these controllers in the description below. I would definitely recommend picking up the Xbox One S controller instead of just a regular Xbox One controller, since it does have Bluetooth and improved range. Twitter and Google Plus links in the description below. I will see you guys, hopefully, in another video. Peace out.